Hello, everybody! Seattle Gamer here, back with some more Nilly's Realm as our priest. So, in the last episode, we talked a little bit about feedback. Was that the Nilly's Realm episode, or was that the regular realm episode? You know what? I get them kind of confused sometimes. But either way, in the last episode, we talked a little bit about feedback, both giving feedback and also how to get the most out of critique, or how to take critique and use it to hopefully, you know, help you out. I mean, after all, that is why you want critique. That is what it's good for, I think. Yeah, speed and death. Okay. We need... Oh, hello. Hello, lag. Hello, lag, my old friend. So, and in the last episode, I had a few people message me after the episode, after watching it, and or commenting on it, saying that they felt like they didn't want to start YouTube channels, or they were afraid to start YouTube channels, or they had already started them. And yeah, man, don't die, Gold Slay. I'll keep my fingers crossed for you, man. I hope I don't die either. That'd be awful. Because they either stopped or never started doing YouTube because of comments and feedback and critique that other people have given them. And a lot of people I've talked to said that they feel like they don't have either good enough knowledge of video and audio editing, or just how to commentate in general, or they don't have the equipment, either the hardware or the software necessary in order to make YouTube videos. So I thought I would talk a little bit about that today, because I feel like that is something that needs an episode on itself, or needs to be addressed, because I can absolutely understand where you're coming from. Wow, we've only gotten potions on things that we've maxed. And it's just something that hopefully I can help you guys out with. So I guess the first thing that I want to address is the notion that you need a lot of gear, or you need really expensive programs, or you need to spend a lot of money on YouTube in order to make good videos. And that is absolutely not true. There are plenty of people who make great YouTube videos, have a lot of subscribers, been very, very successful with their channels, who have not, basically, you know, bought into... Ooh, is that? No, that's not as good. Who, you know, don't use fancy, expensive programs, and who, you know, who basically bare minimum type stuff. And the biggest example I can think of is Grade A Under A. For those of you who don't know, Grade A Under A does kind of like animated videos where he talks about a certain subject during the video, and he's got some characters on the screen, and he kind of talks and gives you his opinion on certain things. I wouldn't really call him a news channel. He's kind of a news channel, but not really. I don't know really how to really describe it. Go check out his stuff. And the reason that I give him as a good example is because he has, it's like 1.5 million subscribers or some insane amount. He's got at least over 1 million. And he does all of his audio recording on his phone, and he does all of his video recording, video editing on, a Windows Movie Maker, which is the cheap Windows thing that you get for free with Windows, right? The free video editing suite you get free with Windows. And he does all of his, I guess, drawings and everything for his channel in MS Paint. So he basically has spent... I'm not going to say he spent nothing on his channel, because we all know that's not true. But for the most part, he bare bones doesn't have any equipment, doesn't have amazing programs that he uses, and he still makes fairly good content. Content people want to watch, obviously, because he's got X amount of million subscribers, 1.5 or wherever he's at right now. And I bring him up because he doesn't use expensive stuff, right? He could definitely afford it. Knowing how much he probably gets paid, I could probably estimate it, right? And he's starting to pull in sponsorship money and stuff as well. So knowing that, he could definitely afford better equipment, but he doesn't use it. And the reason he doesn't use it is because he doesn't really need to, because there's a difference between having skill. There's a difference between having skill and having expensive programs. Because if you know what you're doing, you can make great videos basically on no budget, like using free stuff. You can make great videos, and you can make videos. All right, let me put it this way. If you have the technique down, and if you know what you're doing, you can make better videos with free programs than someone who doesn't know what they're doing, who has expensive, that is very nice. That is very nice. You can make better videos than somebody who doesn't know what they're doing and has the expensive programs and everything. And that is absolutely true, because knowledge is more important than how expensive your program is. I have a friend, his name is Ben Burns. He does a lot of great YouTube talks and talks about, he does more like audio, like music making, that kind of stuff, you know, songwriting and all sorts of good stuff. But he points out that you can buy the expensive programs and everything, but if you know what you're doing, you can get the exact same effects with music creation, with the free or cheap programs. You just have to spend more time and have to know that technique. And so if you're worried about not having, you know, expensive programs or being able to afford really nice gear, then I would say don't worry about it. If that's the only thing that's keeping you from making, let's say, gaming videos, because that's what I know the most about, then I would say there's other avenues where you can basically do this for free, although you might have to buy a microphone. So, man, we are like rocking the defense and speed thing today. All right. You know what? I'm okay with that. We'll use it to feed our other character. So, and let's see what we got. So, all right. Oh, there's a ghost ship. We could do that. But honestly, I kind of want to not have to worry about stuff. I kind of want to just talk and get some of this stuff off my chest, because I'm hoping it would be very useful for you guys. So basically what I'm saying is, if it's a software thing, then you can do better with free programs, you know, than you probably think that you can. And if you start now, this is going to kind of go back towards what we were talking about two episodes ago with you should start making YouTube videos and stuff yesterday. Wow, they really increased the drop rate or something. I don't even know. So, oh, he got a Devo. Nicely done. All right, so what I was about to say was, if it's a software thing, don't worry about it. So if you want to record gaming videos, OBS Studio is a free game recording and streaming software. It's actually what I'm using right now. I have other programs that are paid, but I'm choosing to use OBS Studio right now because it's what's working the best. So yes, I would like to do a sprite. So if you need a good screen capture software for free, then look into that. OBSproject.com, I believe, is the website to download it. So, and then if you're looking for audio, is he No, he's not there quite yet. He will be here in a second. If you're looking for audio editing, then... one sec. If you're looking for audio editing, there's a great free program called Audacity, which I have used up until about a month ago when I started using Premiere Pro. It is great software. I have some tutorials and stuff if you need help with it. Very easy to use, but that is free. I believe that's audacityteam.com or something similar. Google it, AUDACITY, Audacity. Free audio recording and editing. So that is what I would use. Video editing. There are two main ones that I would recommend. The first one is HitFilm Express 4. HitFilm, let's actually vault these really quick. HitFilm is a free video editing suite. I actually use HitFilm 2 Express for free for the first about year and a half of my channel. So if you watch those older videos, you'll probably see that that's what I use. It works great. It's free. It's got everything you need. The only problem is it's a little bit slow to render. It's not as fast to render as... How many whites have you got so far? I've got 0. If you can't answer at the moment, don't reply. I've gotten 6, I think. I think I've gotten 6. So let's do this. Oh, hello. Okay. All right, perfect. So the first one's HitFilm Express. I believe it's hitfilm.com/express, I believe. Another one to Google, HitFilm Express. HitFilm is one word, HitFilm Express 4. The other free video editing thing that you can use is Blender. Blender is a 3D object rendering tool that is also free. And, ooh, there's a Lord of the Lost Lands up there we could do. So that is also free, and it has, along with the 3D modeling thing, it also has a free built-in video editor. And there's a few other ones. There's like Lightworks, which has a free version that's very, very powerful, but locked to 720p. So if you're okay with it being locked to 720p, you're not going to do 1080, then maybe that's a good one to look at as well. Oh my god, we killed that super quick, and we got a thing. So I'm excited about that. So I have never been inside of this ice cave thing. Let's go in. I just want to see what it looks like. Maybe we'll try it a little bit. And kind of stick with the group, I guess. So those are some free programs. Of course, I use GIMP as a free Photoshop alternative. Which is, I believe, gimp.org. I don't know, Inkscape's a good one for that as well. So there's free alternatives. Now, if it's a hardware thing, if you don't think that you'll be able to do it because of hardware issues, when I first started my channel, I had like a 3-year-old laptop that I was using for school, and I had a Logitech headset that I bought at Walmart for $22. And that is what I made videos with. And if I'm being completely honest with you guys, the reason why I started with Realm of the Mad God for the most part was A, it was a game I liked playing. B, it was a game I could actually run on my computer, which wasn't very powerful. And C, I had another reason. Oh, it was free. Yeah, it was free. I didn't have money to really pay for stuff, and most stuff I could run, but I couldn't record, because recording takes some of your CPU and stuff. So that's how I started with Realm. That's why. Could you imagine if I decided to play something else instead? We would not be here today, and our channel would look a lot different. But I digress. So if you don't think that you have the right equipment, I would say do whatever you can to get by until you can afford something better. And the first thing better that I would get would be a better microphone. I would get an ATR2100, which is a USB and XLR dynamic microphone by Audio Technica. They make really, really great stuff. I believe the microphone's about $50. I do not recommend that you spend a lot of money on YouTube until you are absolutely sure that it's something that you want to do. Because there's a lot of people who kind of get into it a little bit and then they leave. And then if you spend a lot of money on it, then you just wasted a bunch of money on stuff you probably will never use again. So try it before you buy and see if it's something that you like. Some people really like it, some people don't. I love YouTube, which is why I talk about it basically every waking hour that I can. So it's just a lot of fun. So in my opinion, you know, like I said, it's not necessarily for everyone, but we have a lot of fun with it. That's why we're still doing stuff, you know, 2.5, almost 3 years later. So, and then of course, if you're one of the people who are like, I'm really worried about comments, I don't think that, you know, I can make good videos, my recommendation is going to be the same as when we talked about whether you should start your own YouTube series, and that's you should start it yesterday, and don't worry about your first videos being bad, because they will be. Just go in with the expectation that they will be bad, and then you'll get hate comments and stuff probably. I still get some every once in a while, but just, you know, delete them, don't let them bother you. And you'll be fine. And the reason you want to start with it is because, like I said, it's technique more than it is what software you have, right? So yeah, you have free software, you have everything that you need now to make YouTube videos. Now you just have to make a butt ton of videos in order to get better at it. Because the more that you make, the better off you'll be. And as you make more and more and more, then you'll start learning how you want to make your videos. And every time you make a video, you'll get a little bit better at it. And eventually you'll get to the point to where it's basically self-automated. I don't even have to think about what I'm doing anymore. I just sit down, I click record, and I record my stuff. So it's literally, you just have to practice. You have to spend time, you have to maybe watch tutorial videos or just sit down with some programs and just kind of figure them out. And the quicker you start, the sooner you start, the more practice you're gonna get, right? So that's basically all I have to say. Basically, if you've been waiting because A, you don't think you'll be good at it, or you're afraid of comments, I think setting reasonable expectations for yourself is a good way to go. If you watch some of my older videos, you'll probably see that they are horrendous and awful. So I just want to throw that out there. My first videos are awful. They're very, very bad. I made an intro, basically, where I recorded me spelling out Seattle Gamer in Minecraft blocks and set it to like piano music. That was my first intro, if I remember correctly. Oh, either that or it was the otter in the chair. One of those was first. But either way, they were both bad. So don't worry about being bad. Just worry about how you can be better. And you'll be well on your way to making better content. I hope you guys have found this to be helpful in some way, or to be educatory. That's totally a word I didn't make up right now. So, or useful in some way. And let me know if you guys are liking these. I've had a lot of very positive feedback with these kind of pick a topic, sit down and talk about it type things lately. And it seems like the direction you guys want me to go in is the direction I enjoy doing. So if those meet up, then that is amazing. That's basically all I have to say on the subject. If you need help with any of those programs, if you need help on where to start, just message me. I'll be more than happy to give you some pointers or a direction to start. I recommend that you pick games that you already know very well and that you are very comfortable playing because it's easier to talk over them when you don't have to really think about what you're doing in the game so much, which is why this game works very well for me. There's not a lot going on. There's not a lot of story stuff. I can just sit here and focus on commentary and not dying and hopefully get good stuff. I always recommend, you know, picking games that you like playing, because if you like playing the game, then you'll enjoy recording it. And if you enjoy recording it, then that'll make for better videos. So that's all I got. That's all I got for you guys for today. We finished our first Ice Cave. It wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. Maybe it's because I was with some badass people. We'll have to do more of these if we can find them. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have an excellent rest of your day, and I will see you in the next episode.